Hey, what is going on, guys? Jonathan Farrell with QSL Marketing. Want to show you guys how to set up a dedicated email sending domain inside of your GoHighLevel account. So this is extremely important, especially if we want to increase the deliverability of our emails, so that way they're not going to spam when we send out emails from the system. So I'm inside of my own GoHighLevel account. You'll see that I have my email set for Level Up Mortgage Lending, and I want to create a dedicated domain to be able to send from that without impacting my actual domain itself. So we're going to navigate to the email services section, and you'll see I've already created one, but I want to go ahead and show you how to create another one here real quick. So we're going to click into the dedicated domain. I'm actually going to delete this real quick. Okay, so this is as if I'm doing this for the first time. We want to go ahead and click on this add domain button right here, and we can go ahead and type in, typically I would either do it as LC, which stands for lead connector dot the domain, or mail, or you know, maybe your initial, something along those lines. It could be anything. And the cool part is we can add as many dedicated domains as we want, because these are just subdomains that we're creating. So in this case, I want to go ahead and do lc.levelupfunding.com. Click add and verify. I'll do a different one real quick. Let's do jf.levelupmortgagelending.com. Click add and verify. And that's going to go ahead and take me to a section where it's going to say, hey, do you want to add this domain? I'll go ahead and click on the continue tab, and it will show me that my domain is connected inside of GoDaddy. So I own this domain through GoDaddy. I can go ahead and click on the authorized domain. It will go ahead and take me directly to GoDaddy, where I can click on the connect button. And once that is, it will go ahead and add those records into the system for me. Okay. Now, you'll see that there are 6 records that are being added inside of the system. Okay. Inside of my domain, I'm inside of my DNS settings right here. And so if I go ahead and refresh, I can go ahead and start seeing that those emails, that those DNS settings are being added into the system itself right here. So you'll see here's my CNAME record. Email JF, that's one that I just made. That one is now added inside of the system. And when I click on this, I can go ahead and click on verify domain. Oh, geez, get out of here, storage. Make it a video. Verify domain. And you'll see that all of these records were now just added to and verified to the domain. Now, it's extremely important for DMARC settings to be set up, okay? DMARC is one of the newer features within email sending. It does not automatically add these, so we'll have to manually add these DMARC settings inside of the domain itself. So what I'm going to do is go back to GoDaddy right here, and I'm going to click on add new record. Okay, now all I'm going to do is just copy these items and paste them directly into the system. I need to add a text record right here. So I'm going to choose the type of record, which is a text record, paste in the name, make sure that there's no extra spaces, and then paste in this value right here. And this will go ahead and add the DMARC record into your GoDaddy domain. Okay. So once I'm done, I can click on the verify domain. It may take a moment, but we'll have a fully verified and set up domain. As you can see, SSL is still pending. If I want to check on that status, I can click verify now. Click auto configure DNS, do the verified domain again, and then the SSL will be added. It's typically a couple minute process, just so you know. So I'm going to go back to dedicated domain, and you'll see that my SSL is now issued. I can now go ahead and use this dedicated domain for sending services. Now, I talked a little bit earlier about how you can set up multiple email sending domains from the system, okay? And so what I mean by that is, let's just say you want a workflow domain to be something specific. You want a one-on-one conversation to be something specific, so that way it's not impacting your email deliverability. You would add multiple domains to the system, exactly how we just did it, right? And then you would go ahead and select this as the domain for the system to be set up, right? So any action that is an automated action is going to fire from this particular domain. Any of my one-on-one conversations might fire from lc.levelupmortgagelending, right? So again, you can go ahead and select specific domains inside of the system, so that way it does not impact your overall deliverability, okay? And then you have your regular default dedicated domain inside of the system, which would fire off as your default, okay? Now, one other thing I want to mention, when setting up email services, it is extremely important that you click on the reply and forward settings. Now, I have this forwarding address in here. You actually don't need to set up your account like this. All that you need to do, this comes unchecked. You need to make sure that this button is checked right here and that that is saved. And what will happen is any email that is sent from the system, when the customer replies to you, it will go inside of the system and also forward to your email address, okay? So again, it's extremely important when setting up your email system that you have the SMTP configured as well as the reply and forward settings set up as well. So anyway, guys, I hope that helps. If you guys have any questions about setting up emails, let me know. I appreciate you. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.